Hi, I'm Dr. Michelle Lee, a board-certified ophthalmologist. Do you ever wake up with eye pain in the morning? Does it sometimes feel like something is ripping when you open your eyes? Do you live in fear that you will wake up with that terrible eye pain? You might have a genetic corneal disorder that goes by several names, including Map-Dot-Fingerprint Dystrophy, Epithelial Basement Membrane Dystrophy, or Anterior Basement Membrane Dystrophy. Before we talk about what you can do about it, let's try to understand what's going on. The cornea is a clear layer that acts like a window in the front of the eye. The cornea has multiple responsibilities. It is a clear, protective outer layer that serves as a barrier against dirt and germs. It is also responsible for focusing light and is responsible for 70% of the eye's refractive power, which is why the shape of the cornea is changed during procedures like LASIK and PRK to refocus light without glasses or contact lenses. The nerves on the cornea are responsible for producing the eye's tearing and blink reflex, as well as recruiting growth factors to help corneal healing. The top or outer layer of the cornea is the epithelium. This is a layer that is about 5 to 7 cells thick, behaves like skin cells, and is constantly being produced. When you have a scratch on the eye or a corneal abrasion, there is loss of epithelium. Right under this layer are the cornea nerves, which is why a scratch on the eye can hurt so much. When you have epithelial basement membrane dystrophy, or EBMD, the top epithelium layer of the cornea is only loosely adherent to the rest of the cornea due to faulty connections between this top layer and the rest of the cornea. If you think of the cornea like a rainbow, the top layer of the rainbow is not adherent to the rest of the rainbow and unfortunately is at risk of breaking loose, which can cause pain and blurry vision. Most people who have this genetic condition may never know they have it. This condition is typically triggered by trauma to the cornea, like a fingernail or scratch to the eye, surgery like LASIK or cataract surgery, or extreme dry eye. While this disease is usually seen in both eyes, the eye that has had this triggering event is usually the eye that is symptomatic. The most common presentation of EBMD is pain when opening eyes in the morning. This is because the eyes dry out at night and the friction between the eyelid and the cornea can cause displacement of the epithelium. This event can be extremely painful and feel like a rip in the eye. My first recommendation for treatment is to use an ointment at night. The thicker the ointment, the better. This should go in the pocket between the eye and the eyelid. And what the ointment does is provide moisture to prevent the eyes from drying out at night and minimizing friction in the morning. If ointment fails or if the pain is persistent, your cornea specialist may consider a procedure called a superficial keratectomy. In this procedure, the loose epithelium is completely removed, the basement membrane is polished either using sponges or a burr, and the remaining defect is allowed time to heal with the hopes that normal epithelium grows in place of the loose abnormal epithelium. If a superficial keratectomy fails after a few attempts, there are other procedures including phototherapeutic keratectomy or PTK, which uses the same laser, which is called an excimer laser, that we use in LASIK and PRK to reshape the cornea. Instead of removing tissue to refocus light rays, the laser removes just a thin sliver of cornea as a way to polish the basement membrane. A last resort for a persistent area of loose epithelium is a procedure called anterior stromal micropuncture, where your doctor will use a thin needle and make small holes through the cornea with the intention for these holes to scar down and help with adherence of the epithelium to the rest of the cornea. I hope this video was informative, and if it was, please like and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Bye!